Hi, and welcome to my new video about what is stabilize. Please note that everything that I'm going to say and everything that I'm going to show you is under the license of Scaled Agile. Please also note that the Scaled Agile framework is just a framework. It's a toolbox. Use out of this toolbox what fits your needs and what solves your problems. This video is part of a series of videos that I'm doing where I am going through the SAFe for DevOps Health Radar. If you want to know more about the SAFe for DevOps Health Radar, then I have created this video up here for you. The SAFe for DevOps Health Radar starts with the customer or with the business. They have bright ideas. From these bright ideas, we are going to identify the hypothesis behind this bright idea. Out of the hypothesis, we create an epic. With this epic, with the hypothesis behind, we are going into collaborate and research. We are going to identify the real customer need or the real market need. Then we architect the minimal amount of architecture which is needed to prove the hypothesis. Then in synthesize, we are going to break down the epic into features. We prioritize these features and we bring them on a roadmap. After that, we take the features and we again break them down into user stories and we start implementing these user stories. We commit then the code into version control and the build server reintegrates our code with the rest of the code and builds a deployable artifact. This deployable artifact is then tested end to end and deployed to a staging environment where the stakeholders can do the final verification. When this is done, then we continuously deploy these artifacts into the production environment. After the deployment, a final verification with a subset of the tests which we have already done will be performed in production. Then we continue monitoring our production system for changes that happened due to our recent deployment. If something happens, then we of course respond to that and we fix the problem as fast as possible. Now it's time to release the new functionality to a certain set of users. Please always remember we distinguish between deployment and release. A deployment is bringing the compiled source code into production with the feature toggle off, and releasing it is switching the feature toggle on. Now we can go into the next activity, which is stabilize. Let's have a look what we are doing there. The new feature is now in production and the feature toggle has been switched on for a subset of user or for all of the users. Now we need to assure that everything runs smoothly. So we need to have a high level of business continuity. We need to do this because we want to have a stable and resilient production environment, which guarantees us that we can continuously deliver value to our customers. Perhaps you remember back in the activity of architecture, which you can see in this video up here, we already talked about how to architect for operability. Now, all of these things that we previously have done comes together in this step here. If we didn't do any of these things or we did them wrong, then we will have a hard time in this step. When we architect for operability, we of course take into consideration the operational needs. So we build up a very good logging where we log out all of the data which we then need when we are in the stabilize activity. We also build up all of the telemetry which is needed, and of course we have the feature toggles to switch on and switch off certain features. And of course we also think about how to recover if something happens in production. Talking about recovery, we of course need to have a disaster recovery concept in place. I can guarantee you failures will happen in production. You can even see that with the big players like Google, Amazon or Facebook. Also there they have disastrous situations. You need to have a disaster recovery strategy in place, and also your features need to be designed to support such a disaster recovery strategy. Which means that in a disaster case, you can switch off certain features that have newly deployed to production. Also, the disaster recovery strategy needs to be rehearsed often, and in the best case, you have automated that and test that often. Because problems will occur in production, it is essential that we proactively detect them. I have created a whole video on the respond activity, which you can see up here. When we have architected our system for operability, we have a monitoring system in place. Based on the data in the monitoring system, we can now create alerts on thresholds which are dangerous. If such a threshold is reached, we get notified. And with that, the cross-team collaboration starts. Now, the whole team which works across the value stream is analyzing the problems which we have in production. They work together, not against each other, and they are solving the problems together. After the problem, we are doing an incident post-mortem where we identify what can we do to prevent such an incident from again happening, and we implement measures for that. In the build step, we are already automatically analyzing statically and dynamically the security of our applications. We scan there for security vulnerabilities in our application, but also in the libraries. But only scanning for vulnerabilities in the newly created code is not enough, because we have already code which runs in production. So we also need to take care about that code. So therefore, we continuously test our services which are already running in production for vulnerability, for attacks, and for intruders. For that, we use the security information and event management systems, which provides us with real-time analysis of the security alerts. Perhaps you remember back in the test end-to-end step, we already talked about the non-functional requirements. In that step, we have identified the non-functional requirements and we defined them and we automatically test them. To avoid service disruption, we of course now need to monitor all of these non-functional requirements, such as reliability, performance, maintainability, scalability, usability, and so on. That's also why non-functional requirements are constraints on every backlog item. Everything that you are doing or changing in that system must apply to the non-functional requirements. And because of that, we need to continuously monitor the non-functional requirements. And this brings us, of course, to the SLIs, SLOs, and SLAs. An SLI is a service level indicator. It is a percentage of an important metric which we have against a certain criteria. For example, in the 95th percentile, we want to have a response time smaller than 400 milliseconds on a certain interface. You can see such an SLI can already be a non-functional requirement, or a non-functional requirement can be a service level indicator. An SLO, or a service level objective, is the percentage of a service level indicator your team must hit over a certain time. An example for that would be, in the 95th percentile, we want to have a response time smaller than 400 milliseconds in 90% of the time over the next 30 days. This is a service level objective based on a service level indicator. Which brings us to the SLA, or the service level agreement. This is the agreement we are doing with our clients and with our users that defines what happens when an SLO, service level objective, is breached. An example for that is, when the SLO is breached, then we need to pay penalties or we lose customers. You can see, understanding what the service level agreement, the service level objectives, the service level indicators and the non-functional requirements are, is absolutely crucial so that we can operate our system. Talking about operations, we of course also need to talk about the SRE, which is Site Reliability Engineering. There is on one hand the role, the Site Reliability Engineer, and on the other hand, the doing, which is the site reliability engineering, which is done by a site reliability engineer. SRE was introduced around 2004 by Google. SREs are highly skilled T-shaped engineers, which are very good in development and in operations. SREs, they maintain highly scalable and highly reliable systems. The whole SRE is very closely related to DevOps. Therefore, let's have a look when to use an SRE and when to use DevOps. Availability is a non-functional requirement. This non-functional requirement is, of course, used in an SLI, which is a service level indicator, which is then again used as an SLO, a service level objective. The service level objective is then defined as an availability target, which you can see down there, which is ranges from 2 nines to 5 nines. This SLO will tell us then that when we have an availability target of 2 nines, we can have a downtime per day of 14 minutes and a downtime per year of 3.65 days. And when we are at 5 nines, then we only have a downtime per day of 864 milliseconds and a downtime per year of 5.26 minutes. Engineering a high available system gets very difficult the higher the availability target gets. SREs are highly skilled people which are very good at development and operation. They are best used when you have a system which needs to be highly available and needs to be massively scalable, which means that an SRE is best used when you have availability targets of 5 nines and 4 nines. When you have an availability target of 3 nines and 2 nines and below, you can, of course, do DevOps. So what is the output of the stabilize activity? The output of the stabilize activity is that we have a stable, reliable, available, supportable, and a secure production environment, which meets the SLOs that are defined in the SLAs. The tools which we are using for the stabilize activities are, of course, the security monitoring tools to identify all of the vulnerabilities, and of course, the AI and analysis and monitoring tools, which you can see over there in orange. The Safe for DevOps Health Radar is an assessment. You can download the assessment as an Excel file by this link down here. The continuous delivery pipeline requires the production environment to be continually stable, reliable, available, supportable, and secure. Please rate your team's effectiveness at maintaining stable solutions that avoid unplanned downtime and security breaches. You are a SIT when we experience frequent unplanned outages and/or security breaches with long recovery times. You are a crawl when we experience occasional unplanned outages but recover within our service level agreements. And you are a walk when we have very few unplanned outages, availability, security, and disaster recovery measures are effective. And you are a run when we have no unplanned outages, we plan and rehearse failure and recovery. And you are a fly when we maximize resiliency by deliberately injecting faults into our production environment and rehearsing recovery procedures. With the stabilize activity, we assure that we have a high level of business continuity so that we can continuously deliver value to our customers. And with that, we are at the end of this video. Please leave me a thumbs up if you liked this video, and don't forget to subscribe to this channel, because the next video will be about measure.